Richard Valadez y estoy súper emocionado de darles la bienvenida a lo que es la cuarta semana de Efecto Ondular. Hoy van a escuchar otra increíble enseñanza que va a retar tu vida, aparte de algunos de nuestros pastores de aquí de la iglesia, y también van a escuchar una increíble historia de una de las personas que son miembros de aquí de nuestro network de iglesias de East Lake Church. Gracias por estar aquí con nosotros el día de hoy. ¿Sabes que una de las cosas más valiosas que podemos obtener de parte de los grupos de crecimiento son las amistades significativas que logramos construir a lo largo de semana a semana aquí en nuestros grupos de crecimiento? Estas personas pasan de ser personas ordinarias a ser familia en nuestras vidas. Es algo muy valioso y muy padre que puede suceder. De verdad, mi oración para ti es que a medida que continuamos aprendiendo juntos de lo que Dios nos está retando cada semana, y también a todos los que estamos sentados aquí juntos con cada uno con otro, que estas conversaciones y discusiones que estemos viviendo día a día les puedan animar a que continúen creciendo en profundidad y que también puedas sentir a Dios dando dirección a las conversaciones que tenemos cada semana. Y a medida de que les rete a cada uno de ustedes a crecer más, no nada más en su fe, pero en su vida, y que puedan ponerlo en práctica. Oro de verdad porque Dios continúe moldeando tu vida a su imagen. Antes de dar inicio a la enseñanza de esta semana, quisiera recordarles algo muy importante, y es que compartan en las redes sociales lo que Dios está haciendo en tu jornada con Dios. Quizás una foto de los versículos que están hablando tu vida personalmente. Quizás una selfie que te puedes tomar ahí con tu grupo, algo chistoso, algo funny, lo que sea. Quizás algo de que un video de lo que Dios está hablando en tu corazón acerca de la serie de Cannonball y cómo está haciendo un impacto en tu vida personal. Queremos que no olvides utilizar el hashtag de Jumping Make Waves o el de Cannonball en todas las publicaciones que hagas en las redes sociales. De verdad, me encantaría poder verlos a ustedes en las redes sociales, en las fotos, y poder darles un saludo por ahí. Así que espero que el día de hoy tengan una reunión excepcional, que sea un gran tiempo de compartir y de conocer más de Dios. Y sin más que decir, demos inicio a la cuarta semana de Efecto Ondular.
I'm sitting here on the shore of Otay Lake in Chula Vista. This is right next door to the Olympic Training Center. One of the Olympic sports that trains here, actually right behind us, is the U.S. rowing team. Now, rowing can include 1, 2, 4, 5, or even 9 team members in a single boat. If you ever watched a rowing team compete, you know that every team member plays an important part, and they are working in 100% unity. They are synchronized in their movements as the team member in the front of the boat calls out the commands and the rest of the team executes. Everyone on the team must play their part for the team to succeed. A rowing team is actually a great example of our primary goal for this ripple effect and cannonball season. Our primary goal has always been that 100% of us across all of our churches would participate in this spiritual journey. We want everyone to participate at whatever level God leads. And if you're still wondering if this is for you, my prayer is that our study today will encourage you to take a spiritual cannonball leap towards Jesus with the rest of us. Now, on the other hand, if you're somebody who made a cannonball commitment about a year ago to jump all into Jesus' mission, then I pray that today's discussion would give you strength to stay in that journey and to perhaps even take greater steps of faith along the way. Well, as you know, in this series, we've been looking at the book of Colossians, a letter written by the Apostle Paul to instruct a group of believers in an ancient city, Colossae. Now they, not unlike us, have been experiencing the realities of what it's like to try to follow Jesus in a world that does not have Jesus as priority number one. In chapter 3, which we're going to look at today, Paul reminds them that to be fully transformed, they need to let the work of the Holy Spirit and the character of Christ find its way into every area of their life. You see, for us, just like those early Jesus followers, the problem is not that God isn't working in them or us. The problem for them and many of us today is that we tend to only let Jesus into selective parts of our lives. Let me give you an example. Maybe we'll give God access to our relationships, but not our finances. Or we'll invite God into kind of our social circles, but not into our work lives on the job. You see, this is why in chapter 3, verse 5 and 10, Paul says this to those early believers. Put to death the sinful earthly things lurking within you. And then he says, put on your new nature and be renewed as you learn to know your Creator and become like Him. I think all of us could look at our own lives and say those two realities are true of most of us. We all have patterns we need to put to death, and we all need to let Jesus move us into new ways of living. In another letter to a church in Rome, Paul even agreed that this tension was real in himself. Chapter 7, verses 18 of Romans says this, "And I know that nothing good lives in me, that is, in my sinful nature. I want to do what is right, but I can't." You see, in the end, Paul not only identifies with the problem, but the good news is he offers the solution. Verses 24 and 25 of that same chapter says this, "Oh, what a miserable person I am. Who will free me from this life that is dominated by sin and death? Thank God, the answer is Jesus Christ our Lord." In the 1950s, a pastor by the name of Robert Boyd Munger wrote a small, now really famous book called My Heart, Christ Home. That little book has sold more than 10 million copies. You can read the whole thing in less than 15 minutes. But like the title implies, that little book compares our lives to the rooms in a home and challenges the reader to let Christ dwell in every space. For Munger, the living room is where we daily meet with Jesus. And the dining room is where we examine what appetites we should or should not be controlled by. But then he writes about the closets of our lives, the places that we need to let Jesus in to kind of clean out these often hidden areas that we don't let anyone, including God, have access to. You see, perhaps one of the reasons the book has sold so many copies is because it touches on a truth that we all realize, that we tend to let God in some places and not in others. And we intrinsically know that the best way forward is by giving God an all-access pass to our heart, mind, body, and soul. Using the cannonball imagery, let's imagine for a moment that you sense God is calling you to take a new faith risk and maybe forgive someone who wronged you. That's a big leap of faith. You sense the Holy Spirit is leading you, and through prayer and through God's guidance, maybe the wisdom of a friend, you decide to take that cannonball leap and extend forgiveness to that person. And it works. After you take that step of obedience and you forgive, you immediately feel like a weight you've been carrying for years has been lifted. You carry less stress. You feel like you can risk and love again. It's literally a game changer, and the ripples of God's work in your life are evident to those around you. But where we run into difficulty is the tendency among us to compartmentalize our lives. In other words, we let God do work in one area, like forgiveness with that one person. But then we'll stay bitter at another person, or we'll keep him out of our finances, and we'll continue to live selfishly. It's as if instead of our life being one big pool that we invite Jesus to impact, our lives are much more like a giant ice cube tray. Remember the old school ice cube trays? Made up of all these little segmented sections, barriers that keep water from flowing onto the other side. But it's in all those little barriers in the tray where the problems arise. You see, those barriers keep the ripple effects from going into every space and every place. You see, God's desire is not just 100% participation. It's actually a step deeper than that. He's seeking 100% access to all of our lives. Not because he wants to micromanage us or manipulate us, but because he wants to bless us. He wants to remove every hint of sin from the world. And ultimately, that starts with our own heart, mind, body, and soul. He also wants to remodel the parts of our lives that have been hurt and damaged in the past by our own sin or even the sin of others. You see, as we open our whole lives to God, that's when we will experience the ripples of change that God has for us. This kind of change is what our theme verse for the series is talking about. Let's look at that once again. The same good news that came to you is going out all over the world. It is bearing fruit everywhere by changing lives, just as it changed your lives from the day you first heard and understood the truth about God's wonderful grace. You see, God changes us and invites us to partner with Him in changing the world. And that is what this Cannonball Spiritual Journey and Generosity Initiative is all about. We are just 1 week away from our Ripple Effect Commitment Weekend. And I want you to know that I've been praying for you, that you would bear fruit in every area of your life, like that verse said, creating ripples of faith all around you. So I want you to consider this, that this generosity commitment, and just this next weekend, we're all going to have a spiritual moment. For some of you, this will be the first time you join the rest of us and make a one-year commitment. Others of us, we're gonna just reaffirm the commitment we've already made. And still others of us, maybe we've had an increase of faith or increase of finances, we might increase our commitment. But I want you to think of this commitment like a rock tossed into a still body of water. You see, it is our collective generosity that will create ripples for years to come. And I hope you will be a part of this. As we've said from the beginning, our goal is 100% participation. All we've ever asked in all of our churches, when it comes to generosity commitments like this, is that each of us simply listen to the leading of the Holy Spirit and then obey. You do what Jesus tells you to do, and I'll do what Jesus tells me to do. And we've always seen that when we respond like that, together great things are accomplished. And so I'm asking everyone at all of our churches to talk to God about this commitment that we're going to make together. I mean, truly pray to Him about your commitment. Begin asking God what He is asking of you, because I believe God is going to speak to all of us about one of those three steps. Jump in for the first time, reaffirm that commitment and finish strong, or maybe enlarge that commitment and see God stretch your faith. Well, next weekend is going to be historic. I am so grateful to serve churches full of people who want to follow Jesus and willingly participate in His Kingdom of God mission. I love our network of churches, and I am so confident that God will lead us and bless us as we jump in again. Have a great group.
My name is Christine Crosby. This is my husband, Brian, and we've been coming to East Lake Church for 6 years.
We have two young children, ages 4 and 2. So what originally brought us to Eastlake was a good friend of ours. She's like, you should come check it out. Like, here's what they've got going on. Here's what, you know, they do. And so we said, oh, let's go check it out. And here we are.
So through this Cannonball journey, we've learned to grow together as a couple. we've been praying a lot more as far as our finances are concerned, talking a lot more about our finances. It's been really good to teach our kids what it is to be all in and to understand what this Cannonball commitment is about and what can it do to the future of Eastlake Church and to help the church grow exponentially.
It wasn't always easy, or it wasn't easy, because I'm the sole income provider. My wife stays at home to raise our family. Things that I want to do or we want to do together, or, you know, basically we have to reevaluate those and see maybe we can do this instead. And I think that that's been probably the bigger challenge, but at the same time, the more rewarding one, because you realize what you really need and what you really don't need.
That moment of filling out the commitment card, it was, we didn't have a number in mind. We already tithe and give to the church, so giving extra was, we had to reevaluate everything. So we had discussed it together on how much more we can give, and we put that number down and committed to that.
I think what we're looking for in the last, you know, kind of season of Cannonball is to really just finish strong and think about what God has for us next and how He can use us, our time, our talent, our resources, to really accomplish His mission. And you have to really believe that you're playing a part and that there is a mission, there is a greater good, a greater cause that's bigger than yourself, that you can participate and change the story.
We can see how our money is changing lives. Also, what excites me is knowing that people are going to get to know Jesus more and probably get baptized also. Baptism is something that actually really excites me in general, just because I really love enjoying seeing people make that commitment to God and knowing that they know the God that I know. So I think that is amazing when people get baptized. So I'd like to encourage you to stay strong and be committed, whether it be giving for the first time and praying about it and praying how much to give, or if it's like us and that we're already committed and we want to stay strong and continue doing it, or if you want to challenge yourself even more and maybe give more.
We can learn that God can take something so that we think is so insignificant, just He can really take that and just say, here's what I can do. And those are that's the exciting part for me. That makes me feel good that, you know, I'm changing the way things are.